From 180 to 23 finalists, students at Blessed Trinity are hoping to win $5,000 for their favorite charity.
Today's our second annual YPI grand finale. Students have been working all year long researching different charities, and winning groups from each of our six civics classes presented in the gymnasium today, and we're waiting to hear back from the judges for the winning group. Presentations are finished now, and everyone's sitting on their edges of their seats.
Why is YPI so important to your students?
It gives us the opportunity to go into our community, practice our faith by giving back to charities. Our students have the ability to represent and advocate for charities in our town and bring back an incredible donation, as well as raising awareness of the charities that are in our town.
Why did you bring the YPI program to Blessed Trinity?
Well, two reasons. First of all, our Director of Education, Mr. John Crocco, always instills in the principals, how are we actively engaging our students in the community, and how are they making their learning alive in the classroom? And through the leadership of our program chair and Ms. Mercury, we had this opportunity to have a partnership with the YPI program, and this was an excellent demonstration of the students' learning and the partnerships they established within the community.
So the Tuscan Casale Foundation is actually donating the $5,000, but I hear your school is doing something special too.
That is correct. We are also donating $500. The difference being is that we have a panel of judges that are determining who the $5,000 winner is. For the $500 that the school is donating, we actually have our grade 9 students who are witnessing the assembly as well choose the winner. So this is a great opportunity for the students to be a part of the assembly and do a vote on their own, and the school is going to give the $500 to their charity of the choice.
Melody, when did the foundation get started?
The Tuscan Casale Foundation started in 2001, and then they launched the Youth and Philanthropy Initiative in 2002. It started in one school in Toronto, and it's blossomed to hundreds of schools in five countries now. The foundation has given over $9 million since then, and every year across Canada alone, nearly $1 million is granted to local charities.
Why is it so important to be engaging young people in this initiative?
The model of YPI is growing compassionate communities, and young people are the next generation who are solidifying their values, and then through the values they learn and the skills they learn through YPI, through the years afterwards, they are carrying it out, contributing to their communities as volunteers with their skills, time, treasure, and advocacy to their communities around them. And so that ripple effect starts in the young people, and it fuels so many people around them.
Sarah, congratulations. You and your group have just won $5,000. What does this mean to McNally House to win this money?
They are putting it towards more grief programs for the families and programs to help dealing with obviously the trouble they're going through and how to deal with someone that's been in your life for forever and now they're gone. So it's sort of a hard thing for them to deal with, and McNally House is there to support them throughout the whole process.
So beyond today and the check presentation, do you see you and your teammates actually helping more at McNally House?
Now, like seeing how great of a place is and everything, definitely I'm planning to volunteer in the future and just kind of helping out with our local community and stuff.
John, how did this group stand out amongst the others?
This is absolutely outstanding for the students in the community here in Grimsby. This particular group that received the award, passionate about the Hospice Centre, passionate about their role in the community and knowing the importance that it plays within this community of Grimsby.
And what are you hoping that your students are actually going to gain from this experience?
The hope is that this will engage them as purposeful, active citizens within our town, and in the future continue their participation in philanthropy in our town and in their lives.
The second annual YPI saw $5,000 awarded to McNally House Hospice. Grade 9 students are already thinking about their projects for next year. In Grimsby, reporting for The Source, I'm Laurie Taraba.